Hello students, we have started chapter 3, Fiber to Fabric. In this chapter, the first topic we have done is the wool. The second topic we are going to do is the wool production. Today we are going to do wool production. So the wool which we have taken from the sheeps, now it has to be changed into woolen cloths, fabric. How to change them? It involves some steps. So what are the steps we are going to see? The processing of the woolen fabric into the sheared fleece involves the following steps. First, shearing. Second, sawing. Third, sorting. Fourth, grading. Fifth, dyeing. Sixth, drying. Then spinning. And last one is weaving and knitting. So the first step is shearing. Shearing is the process of removal of the fleece from the body of animals like sheep, is known as shearing. It is done with the help of the clippers or the pair of scissors or shearing machine. So we have to remove the fleece from the fleece are nothing but the hair like the hair which are present on the body of the animals. We have to remove that hairs. So it can be done by the help of the clippers, pair of scissors or any shearing machine. And the person who removes that wool is called as shearer. The process of shearing does not hurt the sheep. So when we remove the wool from the sheep, it does not hurt. But in fact, the removal of the fleece during the summer month helps the sheep to keep the body cooler. So we always prefer doing the shearing in the month of the summers only. Why? Because if we take out the wool from the body of the sheep, it helps the sheep to keep the body cooler. So hence the shearing is done mainly in the summer months. Next, sawing. Sawing, the raw sheared fleece is washed with the detergent and alkali in the tank to remove the grease, dust and dirt. See, after the removal of the fleece, now the next step is to wash that. It should be washed with the detergent and alkali, because if it is washed with the detergent and alkali is nothing but a base, then all the dust which are present in it, dust, dirt or grease which are present on the wool, can be removed. The process in which the shorn hair is treated to remove the grease and dirt is called as sawing. Nowadays, sawing is also done by using machines. We also use machines for doing the sawing. Sawing is the removal of the dirt and dust from the wool. After removing the dirt and dust, the next step is sorting. Sorting, the process of removal of damaged and strained wool from the fleece. Sorting means taking out any damage or strained wool is present, you have to take out. That is called as sorting. Grading is the process of grouping the wool according to the length, color, texture and age of dyeing is known as grading. Okay, now you have taken out the dirt, dust and grease from the fleece. Now after that you have done the sorting. Sorting means damaged wool also you have removed. Now the next step is grouping of the wool. Grouping of the wool means according to the length, the wool which are of the equal length, they are equal length, color and texture, they are brought together. That is called as grading. After that, dyeing. The natural color of the fleece of the sheep and goat is white, brown or black. Only in the three forms of the color you can see the fleece. Fleece means wool, you can see only in the three colors, that is white, brown and black. So the sheared wool is dyed into the various color depending on the requirement. Depending upon the requirement, you want different colors of the woolen cloth. So depending upon the color, you dye it. Dye means you add color to it. After adding the color, the next step is drying. So drying is after dyeing the wool, it should be dried. Dried means all the moisture, all the water has to be removed. So the dried wool is passed through the machines that squeezes out excess water. The word drying indicates removal of the water. So the wool is passed into the special machine to take out the excess of water. Then it is packed into the bales for transport transport to the mills. Okay, now the excess of the water is removed, now these wool is now made into bundles and then transported into mills. Next, after transporting in the mills, next, what you have to do? Spinning. The fibers after drying and drying are oiled, straightened, combed, washed and twisted and then spun into yarn. So after drying, what they will do? They are oiled. Okay, oil is applied. Then they are changed into straight. They are straightened. They are made straight. Combed means the combing is done to that wool. Again wash, again twisted, and then it is spun into yarn. The fibers are straightened by keeping them under the rollers to stretch them and twisted into yarn. So they are then, after making into yarn, what they do, the fibers are straightened. Straightened means they are made them straight by keeping under the rollers. We can't make them straight by in the hands. So what we pass them in under the rollers and then stretch them and then twist it into yarns. Last step is weaving and knitting. The large fibers are spun into yarn and then knitted for making the sweaters. The last step is making of the sweaters. The yarns are knitted for making the sweaters, whereas the shorter fibers are spun and woven into the other woolen cloth. Okay, the shorter fibers, the fibers which are of the short length, they are made into the smaller woolen cloths. So these are the steps involved in the wool production. See the diagram. In the diagram, you can see the shearing, scouring, sorting, grading, dyeing, weaving and knitting, and then wool. Okay. So this is an important, you can get this wool production for the 5 marks question. So you have to learn each and every step. Next, the leading commercial producer of the wool are Australia, China and New Zealand. So these are the three different countries which are the main leading producers, means in which the wool is mainly produced, that is Australia, China and New Zealand. Bioclips is the name of the wool harvesting technology and was invented by Australian scientists. So Bioclip is the name of the new wool harvesting. So it was invented by an Australian scientist. Now next is health hazards in the wool industry. So what are the side effects of the wool industries? Health hazard. The major health hazard faced by the people working in the wool industries is an infection called as anthrax. Anthrax is a disease. Who get this disease? The people who are working in the wool industries, they are mainly suffered with this kind of disease. In this disease, it is common a bacterial disease. So it is a bacterial disease. So anthrax is spread through a bacteria. So it is a bacterial disease of goats and sheep that might affect the workers involved in the shearing sorting process. So the persons who are doing the shearing and sorting process, they can be affected by this bacterial disease. It is also known as Sauter disease. So the other name of anthrax is also called as Sauter disease. Thus, disease leads to the skin, lung, intestinal disorders. It also results in lesions in the arm. Lesions are nothing but injuries in the arm, neck and lungs. Okay, what are the parts which are affected by the anthrax? Is the skin. Disease leads to the skin, means it can create rashes on the skin, it can affect lungs, it can affect intestines and also some injuries on the arms, you can see necks and lungs. The usage of the chemical dyes may result in the irritation of eyes, infection of the skin, lungs and breathing problems. So the chemicals we use for dyeing the wool, we use chemicals to dye the wools, which helps in the irritation of the eyes, infection of the skin, lungs and breathing problem. Inappropriate ventilation. If there is not appropriate ventilation, that is airy, if it is not airy, high temperature and humidity at that workplace can harm the general health of the work. If the room is not proper ventilated, the temperature is high and it is humid, then it can also harm the health of the worker. Hearing loss is another health hazard faced by the workers of the wool industries due to the loud noise made by the machines during the processing of the wool. So hearing loss is also one major problem. The people who are working in the wool industries, they have this hearing loss because the loud noise is produced by the processing of the wool. Okay, next, revise and recall. First blank dash are the major wool yielding animals. So the answer is sheep. Dash goats are mostly found in the mountains of the China and Tibet, Kashmir. Shearing is done mainly in the dash month. It is done in the summer's month. The use of chemicals dye in the wool industries can lead to the irritation of eyes. Okay, next we will do silk also and the life cycle of silk. Okay, silk is an animal fiber that is obtained from the silkworm. Have you heard about the silk? Silk sarees. So how this silk is obtained? We are going to learn that in this topic. So silk is an animal fiber. So from where do we get? We get it from the animal. So it is an animal fibers obtained from silkworm. So it is obtained from silkworm. Silkworms are the larvae or the caterpillar of the silk moth. Silkworms are nothing but they are the caterpillars or we called as larvae of the silk moth. From the larva only we can get the silk. So there are many species of the silk moth, but the most widespread silk is obtained from the silk moth of Bombyx mori. So this is a widespread silk obtained from the silk moth. This is the silk moth which is from which a good silk is obtained, that is Bombyx mori. Now characteristics of the silk. What are the characteristics of the silk? It is lustrous and soft. It is lustrous means it's shiny and soft. It is a bad conductor of heat. It is very elastic and thus resists creasing. Creasing means it does not get wrinkles easily. It is strong as a steel wire of the same diameter. Okay, it is strong as a steel wire. If you take the same steel wire and the silk, it is more stronger than the steel wire. It has a peculiar natural shine and dyes well. Okay, it has a natural shine and it dyes well. Okay, it is having a natural shine. It is resistant to the dust. Now life cycle of silk moth. The various stages involved in the life cycle of silk moth are given below. The first step is laying of eggs. Okay, this is an important question. Life cycle of the silk moth. You have to learn all the points in the life cycle of the silk moth. The first is laying of the eggs. Laying of the eggs means the female silk moth has to lay the eggs. So after mating, the female silk moth lays hundreds of eggs on the mulberry leaves. So where does the silk moth lay the eggs? It lays the eggs on the mulberry leaves. Then hatching into the larvae or the caterpillar. These eggs are then hatched into the larva, or it is also called as caterpillar. The egg hatches into the worms called as larvae or caterpillar, is also known as silkworms. The caterpillar feeds on the mulberry leaves for 3 or 4 weeks. These caterpillars are allowed to feed on the mulberry leaves for 3 to 4 weeks. They shed their skin at least 4 times during the feeding stage. So when they are eating up the mulberry leaves, they shed their skin for nearly 4 times. The process of shedding of their skin is known as molting, and with each molt, the caterpillar grow into size. So we said that 4 times it will shed the skin. So whenever it shed the skin, it grows into a bigger size. This process is called as the process of shedding their skin is called as molting. Next, third step, formation of cocoon. After the final molt means after that they have shed the fourth time, after they have shed their skin. When the caterpillar have the sufficient grown in the size, so they grow into the maximum size, they ease to feed and become to grow into pupa. Then when they grow into the maximum size, after that they change into pupa. From the caterpillar, they have changed into pupa. The pupating caterpillar starts secreting a thin filament-like substance from the salivary glands located on the either side of their heads. See, when after changing into pupa, what they do? They start secreting. They start giving a filament-like substance from the salivary glands. From the salivary glands, some filament-like substance which comes out from the which the salivary glands are present on the either sides of the heads. From this, they secrete a filament-like substance. They give out some filament-like substance. This secretion is made up of protein called as fibrion. So they are made up of protein. The secretion also contains proteins called sericin and adheres to, means it holds the two filament together. So the secretion contains a protein called as sericin. So this holds the two filament together. Caterpillar swings their heads from side to side to form a figure eight. So what they do? They from one side of the head to the other side of the head with that salivary glands, they take out the filament, they secrete a filament which swings their heads from side to side and form a figure eight. The secretion hardens when it comes in contact with the air and makes the filament stick together to form fiber. So when they come in contact with the air, it becomes hard and then it changes into fiber. The pupa completely covers itself with this silk fiber. So this pupa, the caterpillar which has been changed into the pupa when it changes into pupa, it start giving out a filament like substance from the salivary gland. The salivary glands are present on the either sides of the head. So when they take out that the filament from their salivary glands, it is secreted that it from one side of the head it goes to the other side of the head and it is in the form of the figure eight. This secretion hardens when this secretion becomes hard when it comes in contact with the air and it makes the filament it makes the filament stick together to form fiber. The pupa completely covers itself with the silk fiber. This covering with the pupa inside, this is known as cocoon. This is nothing but cocoon. Cocoon is nothing but the pupa is present inside it and it is covered by a fiber like substance which are called as silk fiber. Emergence, last point is emergence of silk moth. Inside the cocoon, the pupa develops into adult. Then inside the cocoon only the pupa, it changes into the adult moth. And then after that, it comes out from the cocoon. Okay, so this is the life cycle of the silk moth. This is an important question. So I am going to end the session till here. Thank you.